This is the heart of our story. Golu and Raji, brother and sister. And this was their whole world. This one small carnival. The other performers were their friends, their only family. This was home. On that day before their performance, Raji took her brother aside. "Did you forget, little brother?" she asked him. And she tied a rakhi to his hand. For it was the feast of Raksha Bandhan. Although it was a feast day, they still had coins to earn. So Raji walked on tight ropes and tumbled for the crowd. While Golu told his puppet tales of ancient times when demons walked the lands. A long, long time ago, a demon did penance. For showing such devotion, Brahma blessed him with immortality and a mighty weapon of all. Upon receiving, he united the demons to wage a war. Bhumi Devi urged him to stop. He killed her ruthlessly without thought. This angered Shiva greatly, and he stomped, dividing the continents, and the demons were forever lost. But as he spoke, the skies darkened, and the earth shook, and other figures dressed as demons strode through the crowd. These were not masks. This was not a child's tale. As the demons turned to slaughter, Raji tried to reach her brother. He'd been hurt and he was scared, and she knew she must protect him. But in that moment, Raji failed. For the Garasura demons took Golu from her. Raji. Awake, my child. this place?
She is so young.
A child. Remember Shiva's words.
It is so much weight to put on the shoulders of a mortal. Is this one strong enough?
Time will tell. Her brother and the other children had been seized by the Garasura. I told her that she must be strong. Her journey would be difficult and full of unknowns. I blessed her with the Trishul, my most powerful weapon that Shiva had given to me. This, with Raji's own serenity and strength, would save her brother. She walks boldly into a dark cave. She leaps chasms. She stands fearless before a goddess.
Har Har Mahadev!
There is fire in her. Yes, it must be tempered. But without that fire, she would have already given up.
Many mortals would not be brave enough to climb.
Our Raji has no fear of heights. Watch. There, see? She is learning to think and to use the skills of her childhood.
It is one thing to climb a pole and quite another to face a demon.
To save her brother, Raji must face the demons. She held the Trishul. And it was a gift of great power. It was blessed by Brahma, Vishnu, and Shiva, and would help her stand against her terrible foe. But it was also a great responsibility. To wield it, she would need strength, courage and belief.
Have any of Have you seen my brother? The other guard. Go, now, before they come back. Where are you taking him?
Poor child.
She will find a way. Hear your pulse, the beating of a war drum. Feel your heart beating. The strength flow through you. Fight, Raji. Be the warrior. She will bring an end to him.
Jai Ma!
This door is weaker than the other, and the Trishul is a most versatile weapon. She's a circus performer, our Raji. See what she can do. There. Amrit Bund. The golden nectar. The fruits of a demon kill. Its power will heal your wounds. The mandala shows each person their past.
There is always a purpose to such visions.
Thank you.
myself and Golu.
Shrine to Kali.
Your sister's shrines are fed by violence. Raji can make use of that if she is careful.
Om Shri Mahakalikayai Namaha.
She begins to learn the Trishul's power.
Thank you.
You must admit, she shows promise.
She will need battle skills. That is so true, and they will be sorely tested. But that is not what I meant when I asked if she was strong. Ah, Mahishasura, the shapeshifter, the buffalo demon. Evil incarnate. Yet, without him, you would not have come to be. This is the moment when he was granted the boon by Brahma. No man could kill him. And here, Mahishasura seized the heavens, unkillable, defeating and driving out all the devas and even Indra himself. Your birth, Durga. The devas knew it was their only chance to create a being capable of destroying their foe. All their power focused into one body, gifted with all their weapons. I wonder what your first thoughts were. Him back. I remember it well. You on a lion's back leading the battle line. The devas flocking behind you, inspired with new courage. Mahishasura at bay, forced to take his true form. The monstrous buffalo stamping and blowing, crushing warriors with his hooves and throwing them into the air with his great horns. The killing blow struck with the Trishul in your hand. There was no fear on your face, although Mahishasura had shaken the heavens themselves. In your eyes, determination on your brow. I knew then what the devas had made.
What has happened here?
She can feel the foulness of this place.
You are surprised? Mahabalasura's demons have warped one of the holy trees of Bhumi Devi. This is why Shiva imprisoned him, to stop such corruption.
What is corruption? All for exchange.
The tree showed Raji a vision of Golu. Of dark clouds and a gathering storm, threatening destruction on the world. And behind it all, a being of great power and malice.
The route is open to the fortress of Jainar. She is indeed strong, Durga.
She is. I hope she is strong enough to bear what she finds inside. The fortress will be a challenge for her, but she is growing into her power. I think Mahabalasura and his demons will soon regret the capture of her brother.
Beware of too narrow a focus, Durga. If Mahabalasura triumphs here, then what difference will it make in the long run? You must accept that some things are beyond the ability of mortals to affect.
Durga? What is this?
Sometimes that perhaps you may have fallen in love with the human race. Civilizations rise and then they fall.
I will not see the demons win, nor the Christian mystic who leads them. What he did to human baby was a terrible thing. Who knows what Mahabalasura plans now.
Has no place here. Guards! I can't get down there! Golu! Golu! I'm coming!
Of Jeddah, built by the humans and fought over by demons until the Great Sundering.
The defenses are strong. More and more creatures visit. Does he know she follows?
I cannot. I move now.
It is a truly beautiful thing. How did it come to be here?
A gift, Lord Vishnu?
It seems so.
This is a marvel. It is surely a weapon of the gods. Thank you, those who watch over me, for sending me such good fortune.
I am surprised, Lord Vishnu. Your bow is a mighty gift.
The scales must be balanced, must they not? The girl earned her prize.
Thank you.
You shall not stop me.
Another mandala, another vision of her past.
If she can unlock the memory.
Look! Look, Didi! I'm walking! I'm walking! Careful! Golu!
had captured the children, what was their purpose? Had Raji known the truth, she may simply have given up. For this being was utterly ruthless, and the very heavens were at risk. It is strange, is it not, that such a child should be born of such a bloodline at exactly the time that is needed?
Who can say how such things come about? Ah, see, they have depicted Shakti's first address to us. I still hear her words echo. Absolute reality. She told us that she, the eternal font of energy, beyond form and limit, had created us to govern the universe as aspects of her power. To Brahma, she gave the role of creator and set the wise Saraswati, the primeval sound, as his consort. Together, they would create the universe. Prosperity and wealth would be at my fingertips. Rudra would become the Lord of Time, both destroyer and regenerator of the universe, and would grow to surpass all Shakti's other forms. One half would become Lord Shiva, destroyer of evil. Other, but you know this, Durga, for the other half was you.
Thank you.
Her love strengthens her purpose.
Thank you.
Remember, Bhai, whatever comes to us, Ma Durga will watch over us.
She has always been one of yours. And she's correct. You think too much of this one.
She is important. She holds hope for the mortals of the world. Of course I will watch over her.
It is strange, is it not, that a place of such beauty and intricate design should have been created as a bastion of war?
War is the means they are given to change the world. They only give it the respect that it is due.
War is not the only way.
There. It was Golu. Why did the demons want him? Creatures summoned a dark mandala, a portal to another place. Raji rushed to stop them. But the demon chieftain blocked her path. And suddenly Golu was gone.
Thank you.
the demon defeated, the children rushed to thank Raji. But the stone had been weakened by the dark mandala. Perhaps Raji was about to die. Perhaps she had failed. They took Raji's body and they carried it away. As Raji drifted, a vision came to her. Who was that with her brother? What did they want? She awoke on the boat, and in the far distance, she could see a city. Great kings of the past had fashioned it, and had given their lives for it. But now the inhabitants were enthralled to a vast, lurking shadow. Stripped of their own will. The guardians blessed Raji, for she was the only hope for these people. Do I ask too much of her?
Time again will tell.
A white peacock. What can it mean? What are those creatures that chase it?
The Garuda Gate.
But see, Randa has the soldiers under her spell.
A fresh mortal at the gate? Greetings, little fly. Welcome to my web.
shrine to mighty Lord Vishnu. This must be Hiranyanagari. I have heard such tales of this place.
She recognizes the city built to your glory. Are you not pleased, O Vishnu?
It was my city, indeed. Built to house my temple. But it is no longer. A great shadow has fallen over it. Demons of Ranga, in my city.
Her shadow is long.
You must feed them, Raji.
She cannot hear you, but she knows what to do.
See what they built in my name. A magnificent city, a prosperous city filled with marvels. Delicate carvings and intricate mechanisms, mills powered by water, wheels that turn other wheels, that open gates and lift great weights.
Jalasura, demons of water, mechanical slaves to Ranga. My Raji, avoid their gaze.
The peacock, it cries out. Is it hurt?
Do you remember what I keep in my temple, Durga?
Of course. That gives her a chance. But the way is blocked. Look, the Gajan waters are high.
There are mechanisms to lower them. But what does she know of cogs and wheels?
She is clever, this girl. She will find a way.
Thank you.
But what about us, Didi? Why do we have no mother, no father?
They are up there, in the stars, little brother. Durga is with me.
This is a place of cunning. The mills, the water that feeds the green fields. There is no denying it is clever, Vishnu. It is such a concentration of power. And now it is in Ranga's hands.
You will not keep me from Golu!
It is the story of Garuda. There were two sisters, Kadru and Vinita, the most dear of wives of Maharshi Kashyap. He granted each a boon to show his affection. Kadru asked to become the mother of 1,000 sons. Vinita asked for just one son, but that he must be more powerful than the 1,000 sons of Kadru. Blessed by the Maharshi, Kadru gave birth to 1,000 eggs. Vinita gave birth to only 2 eggs. With time, Kadru's eggs began to hatch. Inside each one was a coiling snake. Vinita, impatient and jealous that her sister's eggs had already hatched, took it upon herself to break open one of her own eggs. Inside Vinita's egg was a half-formed bird-like creature. Enraged by his mother's actions, he cursed her, saying that she would be a slave to Kadru until her second egg hatched. And if she did not show patience with that hatching, she would forever be a slave. And so, under the curse of the half-formed offspring, and through the machinations of Kadru and her Naga children, Vinita became a slave to her sister. Years passed until one day, Vinita's second egg finally hatched. From it emerged Garuda, the king of birds. Seeing his mother's servitude, Garuda asked the Nagas to free her. They agreed, but on the condition that Garuda would fly to heaven and fetch for them the elixir of immortality. Garuda, for his mother's sake, flew to the heaven of the Devas. He was too powerful for the Devas to defeat, and so seized the elixir from them. I saw that Garuda did not want the elixir for himself, and so I manifested myself to him. Because his heart was pure, I granted him the gift of immortality. In return, he granted me the gift of becoming my mount, should I so desire it. I warned Garuda of the deceptive nature of the Nagas. So Garuda returned to the Nagas with the elixir, but tricked them, telling them that it could only be consumed after they had purified themselves in the holy river. He attacked them unsuspecting as they bathed and ate them up. He freed his mother, Vinita. For safekeeping, Brahma took the elixir and bore it back to the heaven.
Thank you.
This is one of the mechanisms that will lower the Gargian waters. Is it too much for her?
Cogs and levers. This is no challenge compared to fighting demons.
Reach Lord Vishnu's temple.
Well done, Raji.
Maybe there I can find help.
The waters flow, my poison dispelled. You will suffer for this, trespasser. Siddhartha, the awakened one, the sage and the teacher.
Thank you for your many blessings, Lord Vishnu. I will use these in your name. Guide me, please, my lord, for I do not know why I am here.
Child, save Mayura, and it will save you.